RoboJackets is a student-run organization that's primarily focused on building robots.
RoboJackets was founded back in 1999, where I think three students went to the basement of Howie and they wanted to build a BattleBot, you know, from the hit TV show BattleBots. And they just actually went out and did it.
We had a couple of students that came in that came from their FRC team, and their FRC team was not doing so well from high school. So they decided, this organization has the resources, it has the manpower, it has the technical experience. We can do more than just build things, we can help people.
So from that start down in the basement, we now have this huge organization of RoboJackets.
We have four actual competitive teams, which is RoboCup. They make robots that autonomously play soccer. IGVC, which is the Intelligent Ground Vehicle Competition, where they make a robot that has to navigate autonomously through a field and avoid obstacles and find GPS waypoints. BattleBots, which they make combat robots and they fight each other. And RoboRacing, where we make autonomous cars and race them around a track where you have to dodge obstacles and other cars.
And then we have Outreach. They do a lot of work with high school students and helping their kind of robotics teams for FRC and FTC.
So the Outreach team is really focused around how do we fill out our mission statement? How do we push on and actually generate the next generation of roboticists?
We try to extend our reach beyond Georgia Tech and help out younger people, middle and high school students.
I think all of that just is really pushing our mission statement of promoting robotics in everything we do.
The competitions that we compete in are competitions that even researchers at other universities are also trying to solve.
So we're a competitive student organization on campus that builds robotics. But it's so much more than that. Because when you take away the robots and you take away the competitive aspect, you're essentially left with a community of people. And a community of people that share a similar idea. And when you break it down to that point, the organization makes a lot more sense. And when you break it down to that, like the community aspect of like, how do we make the next generation of roboticists? When you push it to that level, you actually get to see what makes this a collection of teams rather than just a people that share space.
There's just a lot of great people here. We come from all different backgrounds. So I'm from the BattleBot sub team, which is very mechanical, but I'm actually BME, which is not even related to that. So I feel like RoboJackets is a place where all these people can come together and do something that's really cool. And you don't really get to see that in a lot of different, student orgs. So I feel like that's why it's so special, because we have a lot of great people doing a lot of great work.
So I think one of the important things that RoboJackets does is we provide like a way for students to take what they learn in class and then apply it. And we do so by giving them a chance to build robots and therefore build up their own skills.
From my perspective, I feel like RoboJackets is all about applying what you've learned in class. Because you'll go to your physics class or your circuits class and you'll learn all about the ideal conditions and all these little sample cases and stuff like that. But at RoboJackets is where you actually get to test out what you've actually learned. And I think that's really cool because you get a lot of experience, and that goes further when people are applying to internships, co-ops. That real life experience and seeing that, you know, you're not always in like a ideal condition laboratory, you're out in the real world. You're doing a lot of new and different things. And you actually get to try those out. And that's how I think RoboJackets kind of fills that role.
So at Georgia Tech, we do a lot of stuff in classes. You put in a class, you'd be like, in theory, this works out. And 90% of the time, that's correct. They usually don't make mistakes in the theory. But when you actually go to implement something in the real world, when you put it on actual hardware, everything breaks down. All those assumptions of like, oh, we'll just assume this is true, it's never true. And then I think that's the part within the community that RoboJackets serves. We teach people how to actually do things.
And I think the other part that people don't talk about as much is just like the soft skills that you learn. So that's, you know, like being able to communicate effectively, being able to like manage people, being able to manage a project, just leadership skills in general, like learning how to take initiative and coming up with ideas for new projects. So I think those are some of the really important skills that you can also like, that can be useful to anybody regardless of major.
I'd say that as much as we are like a technology-based organization because we're making robots, a lot of the skills that we gain from RoboJackets aren't necessarily just technical. It's a lot of interpersonal teamwork, leadership, and those are all, they have nothing to do with STEM. They just have to do with how to function as a team and help other people better. So a lot of leadership skills, a lot of interpersonal communication skills are all grown by RoboJackets.
Like, building the robots is honestly not the hardest part of this organization. In fact, it's the easiest part because everyone's very focused on it. It's everything beyond that. Like, if I wanted to pull on a new sponsor because we need more money to buy a new sensor, like, now you have to learn how to, like, talk to sponsors, interact with companies, that kind of stuff.
RoboJackets basically functions a little bit like a business, which means, you know, we have to obtain sponsors, we have to create our own, like, branding and signage.
I joined when I was a freshman. I had done zero robotics beforehand in high school or anything. And I just thought, you know what, BattleBots seems pretty cool. Making robots that fight each other, you know, seems like a fun time. So I joined, and then I met all the really great people who are here from all different backgrounds, not just like mechanical engineers and CS people and stuff like that. It's really the camaraderie that makes you stay here, because you spend a lot of nights at the shop just kind of slugging away on the machines or on the computers doing CAD, and you really get to bond. And it's a really fun time being with these other amazing people.
I really enjoyed the sense of community that was part of RoboJackets, because we have all these teams that are working together. It's a lot of people who are interested in learning. They're very serious and passionate about robotics, so that was something that really attracted me. And looking back, the things that I'm able to do now as a result of being in RoboJackets, they're things that I couldn't even imagine being capable of doing in the past. Like, all the, I would say all the technical skills that I've gained and interpersonal skills that I've gained, they're things that I never would have imagined I would be able to do, but I can thanks to RoboJackets.
I did robotics in high school, and I wanted to like give back and, you know, help a team. And then as the year went on and I got more involved in the leadership, I just became really impressed and excited by the amount of leadership and management that goes into making this entire organization work. Because it is completely student run. There are no faculty involved in this at all. So we have to secure all of our own funding. We have to interact with sponsors on our own. We push this entire design cycle, like, driven by students who are already, you know, going to college with like a full course load. So I was just like really excited by that, and I wanted to be a part of it.
With the more positions that I've been in since I've been in RoboJackets, it's so much more about what we're building as like a community than the actual robots that we build.
As an organization as a whole, there's a lot of communication and sharing of knowledge between the five teams. If one team grows, it actually helps the whole organization, because we try to spread that knowledge out among all the teams that solve that type of problem.
Anyone on the entire organization, if you don't know how to do something, walk up to anyone and be like, how do I do this? And they will teach you. Someone comes into the shop and like, hey, I need help with this. I need help with like a class or anything. And no one in this organization kind of goes, oh, don't worry about it. It's very much like, I will help you because I can. And it's much more that value system that goes far beyond the technical.
So we're a very big organization. We have a lot of moving parts, and that is where those non-STEM people kind of fill in the cracks and make sure that we're actually meeting our deadlines and working as efficiently as possible. So we can have different people who are maybe from an accounting background, keeping track of our funds and stuff, and people who are good at management, managing our teams. And there's a lot of opportunities for people to gain leadership through the actual organization, but it's those different kind of aspects you don't really think about when you're just here about RoboJackets is just making robots. Those other different kind of external aspects that are very necessary are where those other non-STEM, you know, people, they kind of fill in those cracks.
Like, regardless of what role you play in RoboJackets, or regardless of whether or not you think that, you know, you could contribute to this organization, like, I promise you that you can, because there's always, like, there's so many things to do, like, outside of even just building the robots. You're gonna find a new group of friends that all really care about building robots and, you know, putting the, like, doing their best and, like, producing the best work that they possibly can.
Even though we're a competitive organization, we don't just measure our success by how many trophies we win. It's not just the factor of how much you win your competition. It's also how much do our members learn? Do they go on to be successful in whatever area that they worked on while they were in RoboJackets? How do they go on to help the field of robotics in the future, whether if they're going into PhD programs or research. So it's not just about like whether we win while we're on RoboJackets, it's about whether you take those lessons that you've learned and are successful with them in the future.